You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
For the community, by the community.
Ladies, on Saturday, March 31st, 2012, at the Simsbury Inn in Simsbury, Connecticut, we are taking the limits off of you.
Get ready to find hope. Get ready to be inspired. Get ready to discover your full potential. Get ready for total success from the Total Success Coach, Princess Bola Adelani.
Welcome to Inspire Success, your monthly dose of inspiration power, the program that equips you with the power and inspiration for total success. That is success at work and in life. This is your host, Princess Bola Adelani, the Total Success Coach. And yes, like I said in my intro, we are taking the limits off, ladies. Yes, we are. On Saturday, March 31st, at the 4th Annual Total Women Conference at the Simsbury Inn in Simsbury, Connecticut. And my question, as I was thinking and, you know, meditating and reflecting on that theme, taking the limits of the power for expansion, I began to ask myself, are there real limits on women? Or is it imaginary? What are the limits? And to just further discuss this topic, I have in the studio with me a dynamic group of women, an amazing group, you know, very small group of women here in the studio with me to further discuss this topic. You know that Princess Bola brings in only the brightest and the best. So it is my great honor to welcome Teresa Younger, the Executive Director of the Permanent Commission on the Status of Women to Inspire Success. So it's a real pleasure. And then Success Coach, my colleague, Success Coach Marge Piccini is also in the studio. Welcome, Marge. And lastly, but not the least, and she's no stranger at all to Inspired Success and to the Total Woman Conferences, my colleague and dear friend, Kathy McAfee. And so we're going to start off with you, Teresa. I mean, you know, you are, your agency is supposedly the leading voice for women in the state.
Yes.
And so I want you to really first tell our viewers a little bit more about the commission, about what you do, and why it is important really for women to have a voice.
Well, the commission has been around for 39 years. It's a public policy agency that helps inform elected officials on the issues and needs for women throughout the state. We also do research around what will help women grow and what will promote women to get our gender to the next level. And in addition to that, we do a lot of public outreach and communicating with women and empowering women on the issues that are most critical to help us turn the curve. So while you talk about, you know, are there real limits? There are real limits that are holding women back. And then there are some not so real limits that are holding women back.
Yes.
So we need to find the balance between the two of those, and we can overcome them. I mean, the commission's been around for 39 years. We started out as a means to make sure that we were informing people and making sure that we eliminated gender discrimination, promoted women in leadership roles, worked on women's economic security, and made sure that women were safe and healthy. Those issues that were on the forefront of the commission and our foremothers 39 years ago are still important today,
yes,
which means we still have barriers out there. I would love to have to be sitting here with you in 5 years and say women have broken through every barrier and we have no more limits, but that's just not the case.
Okay, well, that's true. We're going to get into that. And why is it so important, do you think, that
women should have a voice.
Oh, gosh. You know, women, what women bring to the table, the assets that we have are so important. The perspectives we bring to the table are so very important. And why? Because after all of these years, only a few voices have gotten heard, and we have not grown to where we need to go to. Women are needed in leadership roles because when women start addressing issues and concerns, we address them from a systemic point of view, we address them from a holistic point of view, and we move the process forward. And we as women do what you do so often, which is we are collaborators. We want a whole bunch of voices to the table so that we can make the most informed decision and really lift all boats so that everybody is floating higher. And we've got to have more women's voices, more diversity in those women's voices, speaking on issues that are important to them, because we are not monolithic. You know, we have lots of experiences and different experiences that, lend to our age, lend to our race, lend to so many of the issues that we've had in our personal lives. And that's really important to help us make good decisions.
Absolutely. And you just heard it. It's important, absolutely important for us or you as a woman to have a voice and to speak up and be vocal. And yes. And, you know, Marge, you work a lot with women, you know, in your practice as a success coach. Are there limits? What would you say? Are there real limits or are they imaginary? Are we, you know, what do you say?
That's a great question. And I work with small business entrepreneurs. So I'm working with women who have already decided that they want to be in control of their earning power, which is why they have taken that leap, and for other reasons as well, but that is one of the main reasons. And what I find is that there are both internal and external limitations.
Okay.
But more often than not, the limitations are internal.
Internal. Yeah. We're going to come to that.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
The answer to that is a bit of yes and no.
Absolutely.
Yes
yeah.
and no. Yes, there are the limits are internal as well as external. So
absolutely,
they're both real and imaginary. And what would you say, Kathy?
Well, I agree that there are some very set external limitations, and you just have to look at the wage gap difference between men and women to say, yeah, we're short on a quarter here. We're earning 25% less than men with similar background and experience. So that is an issue.
Yes.
However, saying that, what can women do about it? Is to become better negotiators.
Yes.
And I was coaching a woman recently who had, after a year of being unemployed, had gotten a job offer, was extremely grateful and feeling relieved and just wanted to take it. And they were offering significantly less than she was used to making and less than even she thought the position held.
Yes.
So I said to her, I said, why do you think women make 25% less than men? 75 cents on the dollar. Why do you think that is? And what can you do about it? You're not even negotiating. So I challenged her to go back and negotiate, which I would say was a little risky. I was worried, oh, God, I hope this works out. But she was able to bump it up several thousand dollars and also to show them that she was good at that skill of negotiation. So what women can do to help fight the wage gap is we can become better negotiators, which means we need to know our value and ask for what we need and deserve.
And get empowered. Get empowered, you know. It's
absolutely
all about really
right.
get empowered, mm-hmm. you know, and build up a sense of worth, a sense of esteem, yeah. and get all the tools, negotiating tools, and, you know, really just get empowered and be vocal
and be
courageous.
Yeah, we have to value ourselves.
Yes.
What oftentimes mm-hmm. happens, and I know you ladies feel this too, which is what oftentimes happens is we don't value the things that are most valuable in this society.
Yes.
We don't value at the same level child daycare providers. Mm-hmm. We don't value at the same level home health care providers. We don't value at the same level mothers who stay at home. We don't add that value. And we as women have to make that a valuable aspect of what's mm-hmm. going on and value those things. And understand that, you know, you have to go into every negotiation with the facts.
Exactly, with the facts. And that's why you need to get empowered and get educated
right.
and all that. So we're not going in there emotionally, you know.
Exactly.
And
exactly.
we're going there equipped, knowledgeable with the facts. And really, this is why I'm bringing all the way from Chicago, Lynn Richardson, to the 4th Annual Total Women Conference on Saturday, March 31st. Lynn is a nationally recognized financial guru and best-selling author. She actually manages, she's the CEO of one of Russell Simmons' foundations, the hip-hop mogul. So, you know, come on down to get the equipping, the knowledge that you need to really negotiate and navigate both professionally and personally and grow. And then I want to come to this article that I read recently about women being our own worst enemies. And what do you say to that? I found it really very interesting. In what ways, you know, you're talking about we are good collaborators and, you know, but are we really? And don't we find that sometimes we're the ones that put obstacles in the way of other women? We're the one that, you know, have programmed other women. When we see other women who are trying to break through the barriers and are in arenas that are not traditionally open or known to women, like politics and all of that, you know, we often are the ones that become critical and judgmental, let her go and stay home and look after the kids, you know. We are probably often the times the ones not to vote for a woman in office. And I found that really interesting. And what say you? Would you say that we are sometimes our own and worst enemies, and that we don't really, we haven't really come to unite? And I'm not talking about starting any kind of movement or anything like that, but we are not really, you know, supportive of each other as much as we should. What would you say? Anyone want to? Okay. What have you all been asking?
I mean, well, like a big question. It's a really big question, and there are lots of different answers to it. So how I can answer that is in the work that I do, the women that I work with recognize that it is so important for them to come together, to form strategic partnerships, to be collaborative in their business, you know, to connect with other people who do business with the same tribe of people, if you will, that they do business with. So the work I do helps to create that shift.
Okay.
But yes, it does exist, and it's really unfortunate, but it can be very easily overcome.
Yes.
Yeah, I mean, I would say, first off, we don't have enough women in leadership positions. Okay, in Congress, women make up only 17% of women in Congress. In Connecticut, women make up 30% of women in the General Assembly. There are 8 female senators in the General Assembly in Connecticut. So I think when people, particularly men, start analyzing whether women are their own worst or best enemies in these conversations, I think they're looking at a very small percentage of women, because women also make up less than 8% of corporate leaders. So we're talking about a very small group of women, and so I think that I tend to kind of push back and say, I know a lot of women who turn around and open the door and help put their hand out and help bring women forward. And I think we all recognize that. But the other thing I think we have to really pay attention to is the fact that women are a diverse breed. We are not monolithic. We are, you know, made up of lots of different personalities and lots of different strengths. And the problem that we have right now is we don't have enough women in leadership roles to be able to say, I like this woman because she believes A, B, and C, and this woman because she believes X, Y, and Z. We go, it's a woman.
Yes.
And so, you know, before we can have a conversation about whether we're our own best or worst enemies, we need to get more women in leadership roles so that we can have a conversation about what values they bring to the table, what's important to us, and then we can identify
that. And then why do you think that we don't have enough representation? Why do you think, I mean, I'm bringing to a conference, you know, the executive director and the founder of an organization called 2020 Women on Boards. I don't know whether you're familiar with that organization. And part of their goals is to increase the representation of women in leadership in the boardroom by 2020 to 20%. Mm-hmm. Can you imagine 20%? Mm-hmm. Thinking really, you know, but why then do you think there isn't enough representation? Mm-hmm. Why do you think that, you know, there isn't? Maybe is it, would you think that in the sense of being our own worst enemies, is that we don't invest enough in ourselves. We don't invest oftentimes enough in our own care, which is the theme of the conference, the mission and the theme of the Total Woman Conference, for those of you who are watching for the first time, is celebrate, applaud, refresh, and equip. And so is it because we do not invest enough, you know, in ourselves, and we put ourselves last? And that care that we need to kind of level the playing field, or get us, you know, equipped and really grow and, you know, just to be able to articulate and excel in all arenas, we don't really invest and get. Mm-hmm. Would you say that? Because I find a lot of women, you know, saying to me, oh, Princess Bola is on a Saturday. Oh, you know, Saturday. But Saturday, they'll take their kids for games. They'll do everything else that they need to do. They'll do the laundry. That's probably why they're not coming. They don't want to come. You know, some of them, you know, they look at it and they say, okay, my employer can't pay for me to go, but so the price, you know, and things like that. And I'm saying, no. Look, it's, you know, you have to take that one day at least to invest in your own personal and professional development. And so where do you think that comes from?
Yeah, I say that you have to step out in order to step up.
Yes.
So if you want to move forward in any area of your life,
yes,
you need to step out of your routine and pursue other interests, perhaps this conference, perhaps,
yeah,
you know, we're talking about board membership for,
yeah,
women, you know, perhaps getting involved in organizations that speak to you, that are near and dear to your heart.
Yes, we know that.
That's what's going to
struggle.
Yeah,
I think
guilt,
you know, it's
is it how we've been socialized
over
the
socialized
years?
Is
it fear?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
It's nurturing everybody else, and we're last.
Yeah,
so
on
it's
the
a
list.
Matter of really nurturing yourself, putting yourself first. Sometimes I say hire yourself,
mm-hmm,
be a coach to yourself, and you absolutely must invest in yourself. You've got to put the money, the time, the effort into grooming you. And to Marge's point, not only stepping out, but you've got to raise your hand and,
mm-hmm,
take some risk,
mm-hmm,
to say confidently, I want that assignment, I can do that, give me a shot at it, I'll show you, versus waiting to be selected. You'll be waiting a long time.
Absolutely.
Whereas men are, the hands go up faster.
I was just going to say, you know, when men run for political office, they wake up in the morning, they look themselves in the mirror, and they go, I'm going to run for political office, right?
Yes.
When women run for political office, we stop. We say, I need to make sure everything's lined up. I,
mm-hmm,
need to make sure that my work is okay. I need to make sure the children are taken care of. I need to, and,
yes,
we don't do it. And so, you know, you raise a good question. Why don't we do it? We need to. We need to have more confidence in ourselves. We need to understand that the value we bring to the table is so critically important.
Absolutely.
And if it wasn't for women who are willing to take the risks before us, none of us would be where we are today.
Absolutely.
And it's so important. But I say this all the time. And Michelle Obama, I think, said it best. And I think we forget this. She said, when I am happy, the rest of my family,
absolutely,
is happy.
Mama's
that's
happy.
Right.
and that comes from stopping and saying, I am important enough to invest in.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to take the 10 minutes, the 3 hours, the half a day to go to that conference to fill myself.
Exactly.
And I think, you know, I think women have to stop and be honest with themselves and give themselves permission,
mm-hmm,
to fill themselves.
Absolutely.
And that is what's so critically important. We are asked to give. We,
mm-hmm,
volunteer,
mm-hmm,
for church, and we volunteer to drive the carpool, and then we go to work and we work full time, and then we come home and we, you know, may share household duties with our spouse, but, you know, we still have got a majority of those household duties.
Yes.
We need to give ourselves time to take care of ourselves, because that is what will lead to greater women in leadership,
mm-hmm,
role modeling for our family members to be able to see us in those,
mm-hmm,
kinds of roles and see us taking care of ourselves. I mean, many of us probably didn't have our mothers who took out time for themselves. So we saw them running, and that's how we think we're supposed to be.
Yes,
exactly.
Yes. Well said. Very,
yeah,
well said.
Yeah.
Very well said, Teresa. And you've heard it. You have absolutely heard it. You cannot give what you don't have.
Mm-hmm.
You cannot give what you don't have. And so, you know, you want to take Saturday, March 31st, 2012. Put it on your calendar. Go to totalwomanconference.com and come and get the care you deserve. L'Oreal is right. You're worth it. You know, we are worth it. We
Absolutely.
Are valuable. We deserve it. You know, and just pour into yourself and come and network and meet other women and be inspired and be motivated and be encouraged and be equipped and de-stressed, you know. And then there are a lot of health challenges too, mm-hmm. that women suffer, really, you know, number one, for heart disease and things like that. And I think part of it is because too, we don't invest enough in that care, mm-hmm. in terms of de-stressing and massage therapies, mm-hmm. which are some of the features here, spas and things like that. We don't do enough of that. And I want you to talk a little bit about that because you just recently kicked cancer in the butt.
That's right. Yes, it's almost a year now, March 22nd, that I was diagnosed with ovarian cancer. And so we've got a big milestone coming up. And I look back on my lifestyle before and the wisdom that I now have having survived cancer.
Yeah.
And I hope I never forget that learning.
Yes.
Because it is so much about how I manage stress and what I take on and what I choose to do, how much I deplete my natural resources and not replenish. So that has been a real wake up call for me. And I have to watch myself because
yes.
I love to work. I love to work.
It's finding that balance. It's finding that balance because we are just such great multitaskers. We do so much mm-hmm. and we give so much, but it's just prioritizing, finding that balance, like you were mm-hmm. saying, and putting ourselves on the schedule, on the agenda, you know, and saying, you know, this is me time, this is for me, and that I need
and
that.
And it's not selfish.
Yes.
It's necessary.
Yes.
And I refer to this as follow the flight attendant's instruction. but the instruction is when the oxygen mask drops from the ceiling, place it on yourself first
yes.
before attempting to assist the person next to you.
True.
Well, the person next to you is all of the people in your life that you serve. Your spouse, your partner, your children, your business, your boss, your clients. It's everyone, you know, extended family members. If you don't take care of yourself, there isn't going to be anything left of you in order to serve those
absolutely.
who need you.
And this is Inspired Success. If you just tuned in, we're taking the limits off in line with the theme of the 4th Annual Total Woman Conference on Saturday, March 31st at the Simsbury Inn, totalwomanconference.com. And I have Kathy and Teresa and Marge with me in the studio, and we're just exploring this conversation. Mm-hmm. And now let's talk about the other piece of the conference theme, the power for expansion. Mm-hmm. Okay, you know, the power for expansion. So we're taking off this limit. Some of the limits that we said are both real and imaginary. Now, what is the power for expansion? How do women grow? How do we enlarge our territory? Mm-hmm. How do we break forth and break through mm-hmm. and break those ceilings and increase? Because I really believe, a deep-rooted desire in every woman's heart, or any human being for that matter, mm-hmm. is to grow. We don't want to remain in the same old, you know. And so what would you say as some of the power for expansion?
Well, I think, you know, one of the things we have to remember is the limits are in our mind.
Okay.
For anything that's going on.
Yes.
You know, there doesn't have to be just one person hired.
Yeah.
There doesn't have to be just one job for you. There doesn't have to be just one person you're going to connect with. The world is your limit. And so step outside of your comfort zone. And you can only do that if you're balanced,
yes.
you know? You can
yes.
only do that if you're honest with yourself. But step outside of your comfort zone and continue to challenge yourself.
Mm-hmm. So you heard it. Mm-hmm. One of the powers mm-hmm. for expansion, step out of your comfort zone. That was actually a theme of the 2010 mm-hmm. conference, step out mm-hmm. and step up and step in. And then challenge yourself, you know? Mm-hmm. And I would say surround by yourself. With like-minded people,
absolutely.
You know, and connect with them and build that community of support mm-hmm. of being around right-minded people. That will be one power, and that will be something you will get at the conference, you know, because you'll be meeting and networking and be surrounded by, you know, a very dynamic group of, and diverse group of, you know, dynamic women. And so what would you say the power for expansion in 1 minute?
I think the powerful expansion includes having a powerful network. A
yes.
network of powerful women and emerging women and powerful men and emerging men. But to really build those relationships and to be brave enough and gutsy enough to introduce yourself and make calls and connections and let people know what you want, what you're trying to achieve, and how you can help them. And through that expanding sphere of influence that any woman can develop,
exactly.
her limits
you
are
had
off.
To, Kathy had to talk about networking because she's,
I was waiting for
she's the networking guru. I'm the queen.
I'm the princess. I'm the princess of networking.
And of course, you know her book, Networking Ahead for Business. You can go to my website, royalproclamations.com, actually. I have it as one of my recommended resources. And I did provide an endorsement for it. So networking. And both you and Marge are going to be the networking facilitators. So it's going to be facilitated speed networking. Very fun. At the Total Woman Conference on March 31st. And in 1 minute, what would you say the power for expansion from so many years of being a success coach and a very successful entrepreneur yourself in 1 minute?
In 1 minute. I feel that the key to success is authenticity.
Okay.
It is knowing...
She has to bring that in.
Absolutely. But it's all about knowing who you are and what the unique value is that you deliver. Being connected to your passions and your purpose and living your dreams and your visions for yourself.
You got it. Amen. Just authentic, connect to your inner self. And sometimes you need to clarify that. And sometimes you need help to unlock that.
Absolutely.
To be inspired, you know, to release that, you know.
Yes.
And that's where you get as well at the Total Woman Conference, inspiration. Mm-hmm. You know, you see other women, like women doing that, the same kind of things that you probably aspire to do. And you get ideas and you unlock that passion. And so as we close, you want to share a few other resources that's going on in the Hartford community. I know I have viewers from all over the world, and I'm expecting you at the Total Woman Conference, the fourth annual Total Woman Conference, with Lynn Richardson and all the dynamic speakers and presenters. We even have a comedian this year, comedy skit, and distressing with the spas and massage therapies. We have our Woman of Distinction Awards, and for the first time ever, we're introducing as well an Action Woman Award. I mean, so it's just a full day of care to celebrate, applaud, refresh, and equip you. More information is available at TotalWomanConference.com. But I also wanted to share, as some of you know, that Kathy is on the board of the YWCA. Mm-hmm. And so on March 20th.
In the Company of Women Luncheon, featuring Rosie Perez as a keynote. And you can go to www.ywcahartford.org for more information. Love to see you there.
And then, you have this great one for the state.
Yeah, this is for the state. Anybody who wants to come should. We are having our Women's Day at the Capitol on March 14th. And talk about getting the knowledge you need. We have a keynote speaker that day called Dr. Mariko Chang, and she's going to talk about the wage-wealth gap.
Oh, wow.
And why do we have this gap, and what do we need to do about it? So we'd love to see you. We start at 10 o'clock at the Legislative Office Building in Hartford, Connecticut, on March 14th for Women's Day at the Capitol. Come, wear red. Let's show our politicals and our politicians that women have a voice, and that voice needs to be heard.
That's awesome. I mean, March is Women's Month, you know.
Yes.
So anyway, so many resources. Check us out. royalproclamations.com. Connect with me on Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter. I'm there, and I'm looking forward to seeing you on Saturday, March 31st, 2012 at the Simsbury Inn for the Total Woman Conference. This is Princess Bola Adelani, the Total Success Coach, reminding you to, hey, keep smiling. Life's too short. Keep learning, keep networking, keep believing, keep on keeping on. You're on the winning side. I'll see you next month. And I'll see you at the Total Woman Conference. Thank you so much, ladies. Thank you for being here.